We'll be discussing a few problems from capacitors and capacitance. Now, the first problem is, what difference does it make if the dielectric is introduced while the voltage supply remains connected or after it is disconnected? Now, the first question is, in a parallel plate capacitor, we have air between the plates and the plate area is given, the distance between the plates is given, and this capacitor is connected to a 100 volt supply. Next, a 3 millimeter thick mica sheet of dielectric constant 6 is inserted between the plates of the capacitor. One is while the voltage supply remains connected and the other is after the voltage supply is disconnected. We have to find C, Q and V in both the cases. Now, this means we have three cases. First, we have a capacitor which is connected to this 100 volt supply. Next is while the supply is connected. So we'll show the voltage supply connected and a dielectric is introduced. So say a dielectric is placed over here, and since the thickness of the dielectric is also 3 millimeter, which is the same as the distance between the plates, the entire space between the plates is filled with the dielectric. And in the third case, we have a capacitor. So we have the capacitor and the power supply is disconnected, and then the dielectric is introduced between the plates of the capacitor. In the first case, we'll call the capacitance C0, the potential difference between the plates of the capacitor as V0, and the charge on the plates of the capacitor as Q0. In the second case, we'll call it C1, V1 and Q1, and in the third case, it'll be C2, V2 and Q2. Now, first of all, let's find out the value of C0. So C0, you know, the capacitance is given by epsilon0 A over D. So plugging in the values, now this works out to be 18 picofarad. Then we know that the capacitance C is equal to Q by V. And since we know that the voltage across this capacitor is 100 volts, so we'll find Q, and Q will be equal to C times V. Plugging in the values once again, this works out to be, and we already know that V is equal to 100 volts. So for the first case, we have the capacitance as 18 picofarad, the charge across the plates of the capacitor Q as 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, and the voltage V as 100 volts. Now let's take a look at C1, Q1 and V1 in the second case. Now, you know that the voltage is going to remain as 100 volts since the power supply stays connected. When the dielectric is introduced, the capacitance changes, and you know that the capacitance does not depend on Q and V. The capacitance is epsilon0 A over D, and in case of a dielectric, it will be the dielectric constant kappa times the original capacitance C0. So in this case, it will be 6 times the earlier value, which was 18 picofarad. And this is equal to 108 picofarad. Next, we need to find the charge. And you can find the charge using the relation between C, Q and V. See, you can find Q using this relation, but you cannot find the capacitance using this relation, because the capacitance depends on the geometry of the capacitor. Now, Q1 is equal to C times V. So, now after the dielectric is introduced while the supply remains connected, the capacitance increases, dielectric constant kappa times, so it becomes 108. The voltage across the plates of the capacitor remains the same, so that is 100 volts. And if you notice, the charge also increases, dielectric constant times. So the charge is, this is the value of the charge. We'll now take a look at the third case. So in this case, we have C2, V2 and Q2. See, the capacitance we know is kappa times the value with air as the dielectric. So this will also be 6 times 18, which was the same as what we found in the second case. See, since C doesn't depend on Q and V, it will not make a difference whether the power supply is connected or disconnected. If the dielectric is introduced, the capacitance will increase, dielectric constant times. The voltage we know will change. So let's first look at the charge. See, when you first charge the capacitor and there is some charge on the plates of the capacitor. Now, if the voltage supply is disconnected, so say this is the capacitor and you charged it and then you remove this power supply. The charges which were present on the plates of the capacitor have no way of moving out. They're held up over there, they're locked, they can't move. See, because this is a conductor, and if you have isolated the conductor, the charge can't move from one conductor to the next conductor. It can't flow out. So the charges are locked and they don't change. So in the third case, the charge Q2 will be equal to Q0 because the charges are unable to leave the plates of the capacitor once the power supply is disconnected. So Q2 is the same as Q0. Now, we need to find V. V will again change, and you know that C is equal to Q by V. So that means V is equal to Q by C. Q, you know, is Q0 and C is C2, which we've just calculated here. And you can find the value of V, and you can see that it will reduce dielectric constant times. So earlier, if it was 100 volts, it's going to be 100 over 6. Now I have a small question for you. If the dielectric is introduced while the power supply remains connected, as in this case, do the following increase, decrease or remain the same? First is potential difference. Next is the capacitance. Third is the charge on the plates of the capacitor. And we have something new also, the potential energy, U, and which you know is given by half CV square, and which can also be written as Q square by 2C. A little hint over here, use the formula in which you have the quantities that stay constant. It's easier to use. And finally, the electric field E. And you know that the electric field E is given by sigma over epsilon naught. And sigma is charge over area. I think that hint is enough to answer this question. So for the second case, you have to say whether these increase, decrease, or remain the same.